I'm Dr. Padilla, and we have been covering interactions in Vega-Lite, and now we're going to cover overview and detail, which is a process we're going to show an overview of the data and then a detailed view alongside it. We have been working in this GapMinder dataset, and this is the visualization that we created in the previous tutorial that allows us to pan in different sections. Now, what it doesn't allow us to do is to look at data easily that are in this section here, and there's certainly data there. So what we're going to try to do in this tutorial is to find a way to really investigate what these data values are in this section of the graph. Now to get started, I'm actually just going to go ahead and create a wholly new plot, in part because what we're going to do is use a little bit different organization in terms of the plot generation. We're going to make two plots and we're going to stick them together. One will be an overview and one will be the detail. So we'll specify a constant plot. We're going to name it plot one and we're going to go with a mark type circle. This is going to be very similar to the ones we've previously made. And then the data for that is going to be our GapMinder data. And we will encode this, including, make sure and have a dot there. We will encode this with x value and set the field to quantitative. And that'll be income, as we've done in the previous one. And then the y, and that will be health. And then we'll add a tooltip, which we'll make nominal, and that'll be country. Obviously, this will be very familiar if you've watched the previous video. The other thing that we're going to do is specify a width and height for these. Width of 600, and we'll do a height of 100. So this will be plot one. We're basically going to make a very similar one for plot two. So I'm actually just going to copy all of this over. I'm going to call it plot two. And the major things that I'm going to do differently is that I'm going to add color to this. This one's going to look most similar to the ones we previously made. And that is going to be based on the region. And then we'll do the size of the circles. And that is going to be based on population. Very, very similar to what we just did previously. Okay, well, we have these two plots, plot one, plot two. Now what we'll need to do is to combine them. So here is how we combine them. We'll do return vl.v concatenate, and that is going to allow us to concatenate plot one with plot two. And then we want to render this. Now, when I ran that, I made two little plots right on top of each other. I'm actually going to make this second one much taller. There we go. So we have a small plot on top, larger plot on bottom will match the one from the previous tutorials where we have the different regions. Now, this is good. This is a good example of putting two plots together. What we want to actually do is to be able to select values in this top plot that will dynamically update information in this bottom plot. And the way we're going to do that is with a brush function. So we're going to specify a constant variable, and it's going to be brush. We're going to call it brush. And this, the way we're going to set up our brush is with VL select interval that you might remember from a few videos back. And we need to encode that with something specific across the two plots, and we will encode that with our x value here. So if I run this, nothing's going to happen. If you remember when we had our select interval, there's a few things we need to do. We have to go ahead and initialize this select. Then we're going to have to add a parms, P-A-R-A-M-S, that is going to go ahead and connect the specification we have here to the encoding. And then we have to tell the visualization how to change the encoding once the select has been initiated. So for that, as we're working our way down, what we'll do is add our parms here dot parms and set that as brush. And again, nothing's going to happen just yet. Shouldn't get an error though. That's good. Because we want to specify in our encoding what's going to happen. And we can specify it in the different plots. I'm going to have this bottom plot change, go ahead and highlight values based on what we select in this upper one. Okay, so I'm actually going to add an opacity. VL.opacity. And you'll remember as well from that select tutorial that we need to specify if. So if brush is instantiated, then we're going to change the VL value to 0.075. Otherwise, the default value is going to be 0.05. Some of you might have seen this, but it actually needs to be in codings, plural. All right. Now what we have going on is you can select values in this upper plot and it will interactively reveal values in the lower plot, which is pretty cool. Still, we're having this same issue with these values over here. You notice it's this one right here. When I highlight it, it says guitars. I have the tooltip, so I know that this value is find the guitar. It's been eluding me, but really encoding population of size is not doing me any favors. So I'm just going to take away that size field. So now it's a little bit easier to see all the values now that we removed that size variable. Well, we removed size and it was plotting population. Maybe we still want to investigate the impacts of population. So let's go and change the data that's represented on the different axes with this upper plot to maybe investigate population in the upper plot and reveal it in the lower plot. What I'm going to do is change income to population here. And now what we're seeing is health plotted by population. We're still preserving some of that information we were interested in with the size. And if I select areas, I can start to see for these smaller populations, trying to determine if there's a relationship for them with health and income if we're looking at the bottom plot as I'm scrolling through. Now, it seems like some interesting things are going on here, but it's really quite hard to tell because so many of these are grouped up on each other. So what we can do, among other things, is we can change the scale. What I'm going to do here is actually change the scale for population and make it a log scale. And that's pretty easy to do. We can add a scale here, and the type is going to be log. So now it's a little bit easier to distinguish these smaller values. Notice it's a log scale though, so sometimes that's hard for people to interpret, but at least these smaller kind of areas that were grouped up are a little bit easier to distinguish. So what we can start to do is start to ask questions about groups with similar populations. If I select a range and scroll through these, I'm looking for patterns. So one thing I'm seeing here that's sort of interesting is we have a grouping of these yellow regions, which are sub-Saharan Africa, and then different areas in Central Europe. So it seems as if for a group that has pretty similar population levels, for those in sub-Saharan Africa, we're seeing lower health and lower income. But for countries like Peru, we're seeing similar income but higher health. So that's interesting. We can also do things like get outliers here. So for example, Kuwait. Kuwait has about the same health as New Zealand, but they make significantly more money. So this extra money that Kuwait is making is not helping them become any more healthy than New Zealand or South Korea as well. So it's pretty fascinating to compare these different groups with similar populations. And of course, as we're scrolling through, if we pay attention to my favorite area of interest, which is Qatar, which is kind of right here, what we're seeing is they have substantially more income, really some of the highest income, but that income isn't helping them be any more healthy than Slovenia, for example, which is really fascinating. All right, so this is really an example of what we'd call overview in detail, where we have an overview of the data at the top that we can scroll through and we can get more detail with the data on the bottom. This is a very popular technique, especially if you want to explore your own data sets or if you want users to interactively be able to dig into a data set and find more meaning by examining detail from overview.